Hoy continuaremos aprendiendo palabras del alfabeto en español y vamos a continuar con la letra N. Letra N, the letter N. So we'll continue seeing the letters of the Spanish alphabet. So these are the words we learned today that begin with the letter N. Vamos a comenzar ahora con los nombres propios masculinos que empiezan con la letra N. Let's begin with the masculine given names. Tenemos Néstor, Nicolás, Narciso. Néstor, Nicolás, Narciso. Los dos primeros son nombres muy comunes en español. El segundo ya no es tan común, quizás es un poco anticuado. The first two names, Néstor and Nicolás, are very common and frequent names in Spanish. And the last one is perhaps a bit outdated, so perhaps it's not very common nowadays. Ahora tenemos nombres propios femeninos. Nadia, Norma, Nélida. Nadia, Norma, Nélida. These are relatively common names in Spanish. Animales que empiezan con la letra N. Nutria. Nutria es un mamífero que vive en la tierra y en el agua. The nutria or otter is a mammal that lives in and outside the water, right? Actually, it lives outside the water, but it likes to be in the water. Narval. Narval es una especie, es de la familia de las ballenas, pero tiene un cuerno bien largo como si fuera un unicornio. The narval or narwhal or narwhale, okay, in English, belongs to the family of the whales, although it's much smaller than a whale, right? And it's like a smaller whale that has a very long and thin tusk that it seems to be come from the forehead, although it comes from the mouth, okay? So that's a narwhal or narval. And novillo. Novillo es la vaca o el toro pequeño, ¿sí? Una res pequeña. So novillo is heifer or steer or bullock, right? So it's the young cow or young bull, right? Así que nutria, narval, novillo. Ahora tenemos nombres de frutas que empiezan con N. Names of fruits that begin with N. Naranja es la más conocida, ¿verdad? The orange is the most common of all the ones that begin with N. Naranja. La utilizamos para tomar jugo o zumo de naranja. We use it to prepare the juice of the orange, right? Orange juice. Tenemos el níspero. El níspero es una fruta dulce y agria a la vez. The níspero or medlar is a fruit that is both sweet and sour. Tenemos la nectarina or nectarine, right? Creo que es parecida al durazno. I think it's similar to the peach, right? Nectarina. Y tenemos la nuez. Nuez is walnut, right? When we talk of nueces in general, we mean nuts in general, right? But when we mean, we usually mention nuez as walnut, right? La nuez pertenece a la familia de las frutas secas. Frutas secas or nuts. So the nut belongs to the family of the walnut belongs to the family of the nuts, right? La nuez pertenece a la familia de las frutas secas. Dried fruits or frutas secas is the family of the nuts. Adjetivos, adjectives. Tenemos nocivo for harmful, right? Puede ser un olor nocivo, a harmful or nasty smell, right? Un alimento nocivo is a harmful or nasty food, right? Esto es nocivo para la salud. This is harmful for your health. Negligente. Negligente is negligent, right? Negligente. Y tenemos natural, que también es otro adjetivo. Natural significa natural, okay? So that one is very intuitive. Y puede ser también nuevo. Nuevo, that means new. New, nuevo. Y tenemos adverbios que comienzan con N. We have adverbs that begin with N, como naturalmente. Naturalmente viene de natural, okay? However, naturalmente means naturally and in a natural way. So it can have two meanings. Naturalmente can mean in a natural way, or naturalmente can also mean naturally, okay? For example, naturally I will naturally I will stay here, right? Or of course I will stay here. Naturalmente me quedaré hoy en casa, okay? And we have nuevamente. Nuevamente for again. Nuevo, we said that nuevo or nueva means new, right? And nuevamente means once again or simply again. Nuevamente. Hazlo nuevamente. Do it once again, right? We have regular verbs with N. Tenemos verbos regulares que empiezan con N, como nadar. El verbo nadar, that means to swim. Nadar. A mí me gusta nadar. I like to swim. Él nada muy bien. He swims very well. Su estilo de nadar es muy bueno. His style of swimming is very good. Nutrir. Nutrir means to nourish, right? Voy a nutrir los animales. I will nourish the animals, okay? Although we usually use another verb to nourish the animals, right? We say to feed the animals. Alimentar los animales. We usually use nutrir in its reflexive form. Nutrirse. Nutrirse, which means to nourish oneself. There, we do use nutrir a lot. Me voy a nutrir. I will nourish myself. Oh, esto se está nutriendo. This is nourishing itself. Or the animals are nourishing itself. Okay? And notar. Notar means to notice or to realize. Okay? Acabo de notar que el piso está sucio. Acabo de notar que el piso está sucio. I have just realized that the floor is dirty. Or I have just noticed that the floor is dirty. Acabo de notar que no estoy solo en casa. I have just noticed that I'm not alone at home, okay? So, notar is to notice or to realize. Y tenemos verbos irregulares con N. Tenemos el verbo nacer, that is to be born, okay? Nacer, to be born. Yo nazco, I am born. Él nació ayer, he was born yesterday. Tenemos el verbo negar, que significa that means. Negar significa to deny. No niegues los hechos. Don't deny the facts, okay? Or, él me está negando entrada a su casa. He's denying me, or actually, he's not allowing me to get into his house, okay? So, negar can also be to not to allow somebody. So negar is to deny and also not to allow somebody, okay? And we have nevar. Nevar, to snow. To snow. Está nevando mucho afuera. Outside it is snowing very much. Ayer nevó demasiado y hoy está lleno de nieve. Yesterday it snowed too much and today it's full of snow, okay? So, our irregular verbs are nacer, negar, nevar. In our next class, I will very quickly show you how to conjugate these three irregular verbs, and then we will probably see some examples using these irregular verbs, okay? So, thanks for watching.